Hi, my name is Beyhan. In this video, I will show you how to install PostgreSQL Server on Ubuntu VirtualBox and how to configure for connections from pgAdmin PostgreSQL client. If you don't know how to install Ubuntu on VirtualBox, please check my previous video, which is available on YouTube. Just go for page Coding for Fun. How to install Ubuntu on VirtualBox and how to configure a port for SFTP and SSH. We start with starting VirtualBox. I start my virtual machine. Virtual machine is ready. Now we will open Firefox. We will search for PostgreSQL Ubuntu installation. We go to PostgreSQL site. There are actually just four commands. So I copy the first one. I go to terminal, right click it, paste, and enter. I go for second command, terminal, paste, and this is asking me password. Password is Ubuntu. And third one, we got an error and we need to run with a new parameter. Fix missing parameter. Update is successful. Now we will continue with PostgreSQL installation. Some packages are being updated at the background, so we need to wait for the process to finish. We have process here available. If you want, we can kill it, but it will create a new process. So just to show you, I think we are lucky. Now installation has started. PostgreSQL is installed. Let's check if service is running for PostgreSQL. And it is active. After installing PostgreSQL Server on Ubuntu, PostgreSQL creates a new user for itself. It's called Postgres. And you can see this new user in password file. This last user is added after Postgres installation, and we can use psql command tool with this user. So if we switch to this user, we are already connected to PostgreSQL server, and this lists the databases. And let's check the users and roles, and the users are synonyms in PostgreSQL. So when we say roles, we mean users, vice versa. So there's only one user, Postgres. We will be creating a new user here. With this new user, we will be connecting from pgAdmin, and we will be connecting with this user with the password. Postgres user is a peer user, and peer users both exist on PostgreSQL server roles and also on Ubuntu as a user, as you have seen previously. So they don't need to enter any password. And the reason is, if you check the settings file, which we'll be editing shortly, we will see Postgres user is already defined there. So we are going to settings folders of PostgreSQL. If we list the files, there are two important files for us. One of them is pghpa.conf file, other one is postgres.conf file. First, we will go with postgres.conf file, and we will be changing this file to accept all the connections from all IP addresses. We will be using nanotext editor. And I will add here a new line. Control S, Control X. This file is changed. And we go for the next file. This file is all about roles and permissions. Here we will be adding two new lines. First one will be for the new user that we will be creating, pressed up between words. And the username will be admin. And the connection will be MD5. As you can see, for Postgres, it is peer. That means, as I explained previously, this user both exists on PostgreSQL roles and on Ubuntu as a user, and it doesn't need to enter any password to connect to PostgreSQL. To allow connections for all the roles from all the IP addresses. Control S, Control X. We have changed the configuration files. Now we need to restart our PostgreSQL service. Let's check if it is running fine. Everything's fine. Now we will be adding our user. And to get the user, we need to use psql command tool. And as you have seen previously, only Postgres user can do that. So what we will do is we will switch to the user again. And we'll be again running the psql command. And here we will be saying create role admin with, now we will be writing privileges, login, and the rest I will be just checking here. Okay, super user, create db, create role, inherit replication, no connection limit, and password will be admin again. Since this is just an experiment environment, we don't need to worry about much. But if you are using it for production, then you need to be careful with the permissions and the passwords. Role is created. Now we will continue with the pgAdmin tool installation. To install pgAdmin, we need to go to pgAdmin download page. I will be installing only the web edition on Ubuntu, and then I will be installing the Windows edition to my host machine. So actually there is only 5 commands here. First one is we need to run this. And we don't have curl application, so we will get it. Now we will be running first command again. Done. And the second one. Done. And we will be installing only the web edition. pgAdmin web client installation is completed, but we have one more step, which is the configuration. So we need to run configuration script. I will give a dummy email address. It doesn't need to be real, and the password will be Ubuntu. This is just for the web client portal connection. Web client configuration is completed. Now we need to configure a firewall to allow port 80. New rule is added. Now we need to enable it. And let's check the status. Now if we go to Firefox, we should be able to use web client. Remember the username we have given ubuntu@ubuntu.com and the password was Ubuntu. Now pgAdmin is ready to be used. We just need to add our server here. We have created a specific user for that. And I will change the server name to Ubuntu. Save. And now we are connected to our local PostgreSQL server. And we can see all the databases, create new ones, create roles, because admin user have all the rights. The configuration that I have done to create server, I could do exactly the same one from our Windows host. Let's see how we can connect to pgAdmin web client on Ubuntu virtual machine from Windows. For that, first we need to go to settings. I need to go to network, advanced. And I just need to add a new forwarding rule. And it will be web. I write here my Windows host local IP address and port 80. This is the IP address of Ubuntu. I will show you with ifconfig in a second. And that is completed too. If I go to terminal and if I run ifconfig, as you can see, this is the same IP address that I have been writing to port forwarding. Now I go to Chrome browser on my Windows host machine. I say 127.0.0.1 pgAdmin4. Now it is connected to Ubuntu. And if I give the username and password, now we are connected to Ubuntu pgAdmin web client. And if I add a new server, and I can do the exact same thing that I have done on Ubuntu Firefox, I can do it from here now. Now we will continue with pgAdmin Windows client installation, and we will see how to connect directly to PostgreSQL on Ubuntu virtual machine from Windows client. To allow connection to PostgreSQL directly, we need to allow PostgreSQL port on firewall, that's it. And the port is 5432, but if you want to see where the port is, you just need to check the config file. and it was just under the IP address that we have written. See, 5432, we have just added this line previously and port was here. Now I exit with Ctrl X. Now I will be adding this port to firewall. And I will enable firewall. And I will check the status if everything's fine. As you can see, 5432 is added. I start installing pgAdmin for Windows. Installation is completed. Now pgAdmin client is ready to be used on Windows. It requires a master password. I will write Ubuntu here. Now we are ready to add a new server. Basically, I will repeat the same steps that I have done on web clients. Just the difference, on web client we have written local IP address of Ubuntu here. Now we will be writing for our Windows local IP, and port 5432 will be forwarded to virtual machine port 5432. But before that, I think we forgot to add the forwarding. Yes, we need to edit here. Now we are ready. We will continue with admin user. Password is admin. Save password. Save. And that's it. Now we are connected to Ubuntu PostgreSQL Server from our Windows pgAdmin client 2. Let's add a new database here. Testdb, and owner will be admin again. You can check the SQL command that is running at the background. I say save. And our new database is added. Basically, that's it. This is how you will install PostgreSQL and pgAdmin, and what you need to do for configuration to connect locally or from any host. If you are running that on public IP, you need to be a bit careful with the permissions and the passwords. And this is running on just on a virtual machine. I am preparing that setup to install PostgreSQL on VPS to use it as a backend relational database for myself. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching.